Finish him off, and we'll go for a drink!
What's all this?
Not so fast, Your Excellency.
Gladstone, that bloody man! He will pay for this!
Thank you. What do you intend to do about Gladstone, young man?
I assure you, madam, Gladstone is innocent in this.
But he tried to kill my husband.
Well, we'll look into Gladstone. Perhaps you can help me with another inquiry, madam. A gentleman with ties to Parliament, older, wears cavalry uniforms and has a large mustache.
You seem like a rough-and-ready sort of fellow, Mr. Fry.
Well, yes, I am, actually.
And are you familiar with the poorer districts of our city?
Roughly.
Wonderful. As it happens, I've been eager to tour the Devil's Acre. If you were to escort me, I'd be happy to assist you in your inquiry.
That strikes me as a dangerous idea.
Then it's settled. Come back here to Downing Street tomorrow night, 8 o'clock sharp. Good day, Mr. Fry.
But I...
Good day, Mr. Fry!
waiting on you, Max.
Can't do it. Isn't that right, Max?
Huh?
means we can't pay this.
My fees are not negotiable.
You chose the wrong home to barge in. You've got some bloody nerve. You can show yourself out now.
Interesting.
Ooh.
Turn out a priest.
Watch out! Keep your woman off me!
It's not what you said enough.
Some of us have to work and stop playing
white ranks.
Oh, he looks like a bloody idiot to me.
You looking for me?
Oh!
charge for the rook boy!
Keep your head, and we'll be all right.
Terminus for you, my friend.
Give me the news.
More than ever.
Already misguided the public, Hades.
I can't tolerate this any longer. We must free you from the abusive monster. Lord be down.
Madam?
Mr. Fry.
Ready to take the air? Devil's Acre should just be coming alive.
I'm afraid I must cancel our engagement. The lawn is crawling with scandal-hunting journalists, and I simply cannot be seen in the company of someone so...
I'll see them off.
You follow along when it's clear.
Yes, yes. Be gentle, won't you? The press are notoriously touchy about any violence to their person.
Ha ha ha. I'll barely ruffle a hair on their heads.
Shh, Desmond.
That's yours, if you can get those chaps over there to follow me.
Right you are, sir. Blimey! Look! Esquire Bancroft!
Best lead them astray before they tear me to shreds.
Mr. Bancroft! Mr. Bancroft! What's coming up next for the Prince of Wales?
Will you be performing Mr. Robinson's new work?
Who will you be playing?
Young man. Dizzy ought to keep you on to deal with the liberals.
There, in the cart, is the Prime Minister's wife.
I really must not be seen here, Mr. Fry.
Who's a good horse? You are.
Oh, what a rough place. Give me your arm, Mr. Fry. Let us see what the Devil's Acre has to offer.
Dog quite all right.
Oh, Desmond's fine. He's just not overfond of strangers. Or cats.
Do
you know this gentleman is a yes, a costermonger, of all things. Remarkable how the working classes occupy themselves, isn't it?
Very industrious, I'm sure.
Come on, Bishop.
Shall we go?
That was the Eucharist.
I'm so sorry. I have no earthly idea what you're talking about.
Mrs. Disraeli. Everything all right?
Oh, yes. I've just learned to whistle.
Right.
Why, Mr. Fry? I do believe that man is drunk.
I expect you're right,
ma'am. Mr. Fry, look at those two. I'm going to ask what he's having.
Yes, they seem to be, perhaps you'd let me recommend something instead.
I'm fully aware of what they're doing. God bless them. What sort of meat is that man selling?
Best not to ask.
Why? Is it something dreadful? Is it rat?
Here we are. The old one-ton pub. Best beer in the Devil's Acre. I don't mean to be indelicate, given the...
So, this is a pint, is it? Remarkable.
Nice doggy.
Good boy, Desmond. Hand over the mutt.
You'll change your tune when me and my friends find you.
Now then, Desmond, to get you back to your mistress, whom I've just left entirely unattended in one of London's most dangerous pubs.
Well, if you never told your father how you felt about him, how was he supposed to know?
I never thought of it that way. I suppose deep down we all just want to be loved.
Just so. Here, have a sweetie. Oh, Desmond and Mr. Fry, I'd like you to meet... Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
John the Tosser.
Charmed. I think we'd better get you home.
Right you are, Mr. Fry. Come along, Desmond.
Well, well, well. If it isn't the dog walker.
Now, let's not do something we'll regret.
And enlightening evening, Mr. Fry.
No, thank you, madam. Perhaps now you might tell me about the man in the Hussar's uniform.
Quite right. Lord Cardigan That's is the gentleman right. you seek. Ties. Oh! Always blathering on about his military adventures.
Do you know where I might find him for a private conversation?
I do indeed. He's in town now, as it happens, campaigning against the Corrupt Practices Bill. Perhaps you could catch him in the Palace of Westminster. Oh, do be careful. The government could ill afford another scandal.
I assure you, I'll be very discreet. Keep moving. Who's a good horse? You are. Steady on. Your stop, madam.
My stop. How delightful. Thank you. Thank you for a splendid evening, Mr. Fry. I shall be sure to speak highly of you to Dizzy. Oh, yes.
Mm.
Cut your tongue out!
Fine, Mr. Fry. Buy back time for you, Piggy!
I'll catch you!
Take it easy, Linton. Settle down now.
Somebody's gonna pay for this!
Oh, I'll enjoy carving you!
Straight off by a Russian cannonball.
Of course he is, yeah.
Have a sweet
cannonball.
boy all the way from Canada.
You don't say.